Now, you may not have heard his name, but it might pay to remember it. Adelaide teen Thanasi Kokkinakis is on the way to becoming our next tennis star, making a name for himself on the international circuit. Reporter Vassal Melandris was brave enough to take on the young gun at his own game.
I can't tell where the journey will end, but I know where to start.
I'm playing all the tournaments every tennis player wants to play. That's what you train hard for.
They say I'm caught up in a dream.
We're hoping he's poised for bigger and better things.
I've always thought he's had something pretty special.
He's got the serve.
My hardest serve in January was about 207, 208 kilometres.
And the drive.
Can you see yourself being world number one?
I'm hoping. I feel like I can.
But his feet are planted firmly on the ground.
There's a lot of things that need to fall into place, a lot of hard work, a lot of things. You need to be really lucky with injuries, everything to go your way.
He knows his place. He's the last one in the family and he knows his place.
Adelaide tennis prodigy and world top 10 junior, Thanasi Kokkinakis, has just capped off a dream run on the international circuit.
It's been a pretty amazing year for you, hasn't it?
Yeah, it's been a good year for me. I've been pretty lucky with the tournaments I've played.
Wowing his peers, stifling his competition, and winning over some pretty high-profile sponsors.
I got my Nike contract, Babolat contract. My dad's been my biggest sponsor so far.
Send this one home.
The 17-year-old got his break last year at the Hopman Cup and soon after made it to the final of the Australian Open Juniors.
Kokkinakis thinks otherwise.
But on the eve of a possible Grand Slam victory, he suffered a major blow.
He got diagnosed with stress fractures in the back.
Unlike many notorious tennis dads, Trevor didn't want to push Thanasi.
And I said to him, I said, mate, your call. If you're not feeling up to it, don't go out there and half-ass it or anything like that.
Determined, Thanasi played on, and while he narrowly lost, he won the admiration of many.
It was the effort that Thanasi put in that I was particularly proud of.
The mantelpiece isn't short of a few trophies either. He's now added a Wimbledon doubles crown and was runner-up in the boys' US Open.
Come on, move those feet, get up to that.
Todd Langlan has coached Thanasi for 10 years.
We always said from age 20 we wanted him being able to compete for Grand Slams and win the big trophies. So, Davis Cup, Grand Slam tennis is what it's all about. So hopefully he can do it.
But with all this hype, I had to see for myself just how good he is, posing undercover as a pro.
I think we've got to bring someone serious on. This guy's taken out some of the big locals, Abelthwaite, Richards. We're going to give him a crack. What do you think?
Let's do it.
Vass! What are you doing?
It didn't start off too bad. But sure enough, I was run off the court.
That's all. I'm out.
Thank you.
Thanks for the game.
Impressive.
I could do with some pointers though.
Vassal was terrible. As I said, he played the role of the bad tennis player extremely well.
Gee, thanks, coach. Back in the real world, Thanasi's next major challenge awaits, partnering Pat Cash for the World Tennis Challenge at Memorial Drive.
He's the type of kid where he gets a little bit of a roll on. He actually, rather than shrink back and get embarrassed by it, he actually grows with it.
Still, Dad Trevor says it's a critical time for the junior as he transitions into the senior ranks.
Here in Australia, we have got an appalling record of good juniors not actually making that transition and going on and be successful senior players. So I'm very mindful of that.
In the meantime, watch this space as the team sensation takes on the world's best.